Hi, I'm Tyler Oakley.
And I'm Becca Frucht.
And welcome to Top That, your weekly pop culture cheat sheet to what everyone is and will be talking about on the web.
Each week, Tyler and I attempt to top each other with our own top five of what's hot on the web, everything you need to know.
And we are looking to see if you can top us by submitting your own must-know items in the comments below.
Tyler?
Yes, Becca?
I believe it is time.
Okay, do you have a good number five? Are you ready to bring it?
Yep, I'm ready.
What you got?
I can do it. All right, so my number five is The Lion King. Not what you think, I'm talking about Larry King and Snoop Lion. Straight G's for life.
Still on the break, why are we moving? That's me hitting the switch, baby.
On Snoop Dogg's show on the GGN network, which
wait,
is
Snoop
just,
has a show?
Yes, he has a show. You need to be watching
that's
this.
That's the number five
okay?
to begin with.
Like Larry is just kicking back, telling him stories about Frank Sinatra.
Normal.
Hanging out, and it's Snoop, they switch places.
Hey, if you don't know, you won't know. You're inside the GGN News Network. I'm your host with the most. Here's a toast to the boogie.
The best part, though, might be when Snoop is like, I'm gonna teach you to rap. They spit some lyrics about dinner for two.
You are so hip.
About peanut butter.
Jiffy peanut butter is what I love. I prefer it all others above. I'm with the lion and he loves to sing. How about a little ring-a-ding-ding?
He really has mad skills.
Well, speaking of dynamic duos and interesting mashups, my number five is a little bit similar. We have Steve Buscemi and Emma Watson mashed into one face. Did you see this video?
No. I need to see this.
I don't know if I have a bag of tricks that I'm conscious of.
What is that?
We still live in a so-called man's world, and I hope that changes.
It is literally everything that nightmares are made of. If you have like something that keeps you up at night, but you like can't remember it when you wake up, it's this.
All right, here's my number four. I can see your halo. Oh no, actually that's a fan eating your weave.
What?
Beyonce was in the middle of her concert doing her thing. Her beautiful tresses are blowing and they get caught up in her fan, because y'all know she always has a fan on the go. This woman is such a pro, does not skip a beat. She's just singing, her head's getting eaten behind her.
They don't call her the queen for nothing.
No.
She does not stop for anything.
Mm-mm. Oh fan, you don't think you're irreplaceable? In a box to the left. I'm done with you, fan. She also poked fun at herself. I mean, that's why we love her the most. She wrote some lyrics to the song. She redid the lyrics of Halo to commemorate this moment where a fan tried to come for her and she was like, no.
This is probably her most intense fan experience of all time.
Fan.
But I love it because it's like, you know what? She just keeps going. No other queen. You cannot face her.
I mean, we knew she was capable of this, but now we have actual proof. It's on camera, people. Okay?
Okay, well, my number four is another feud that is legendary, and that is a raccoon against the dog of the founder of Digg. And
this
I don't know if you've seen this video. I was screaming when I saw it because this raccoon is going at it with this dog, and this man who loves his dog, God bless, he runs up, takes the raccoon, throws it across.
No,
like
he like launches it, like catapults it from its like head or something.
He has no time for this raccoon. And then he picks it up again and throws it down some stairs. And it's not just like a normal throw. You see the raccoon.
Wait, he throws it twice?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Raccoons are rabid. You need to like take care of it. That raccoon would have came back and gotten him. Like, I don't know if you've ever seen a raccoon can like take a human down.
I'm against animal cruelty.
But
I'm
this
not
raccoon.
Into this, but I also understand the way the world works, you defend your own. Even PETA came out and said, listen.
PETA said, and I quote, you can't fault a man for reacting to save his dog. Maybe it was provoked. Maybe this raccoon was provoked.
Listen,
the untold story of this raccoon.
Say raccoon again.
Raccoon. What do you mean?
That's an interesting way to pronounce it. Say it one more time for me.
Raccoon.
Oh my God. I would like to see Sharknado versus this raccoon, personally. Or maybe just versus Kevin Rose.
Raccoonado.
Oh.
You're welcome.
Okay, for my number three, can I get a drum roll, please?
Sure.
I'm talking about the drumming grandma who is slaying the internet.
Oh my gosh, this was so good.
Now, let's disclaimer here. She's not an actual grandma. She doesn't have grandkids. She rolls up in this La Crosse, Wisconsin drum shop. She's been doing it before. They're like, we got to get this on tape because they know an internet hit when they see it.
Got to monetize.
And she wails on these drums. doing like sweet moves. She started the first all-girls band in like her town. You know, so she's a pioneer. And she hasn't been playing.
I'm skeptical of the validity of that fact, but.
No, true, true. Don't question drumming, Grandma, okay? She had to sell her drum kit. Internet, did you hear that?
Kickstart.
She had to sell her drum kit. Can someone sort that out?
Yeah.
Like immediately? Didn't we send the life savings back to that dude who like tried to win a Rasta banana or whatever?
Yeah.
This is far more worthy.
This is far more deserving.
This is far more worthy.
Let's get her a drumstick or something.
No, we need to get her a sick drum kit. And I want like Phil Collins to sign it. And Travis Barker.
And Animal. So for my number three, we have a monumental moment in music history. One Direction's Best Song Ever video broke the Vevo record for most views in 24 hours. This is huge because the record was previously held by Miley Cyrus for We Can't Stop with 10.7 million,
Turns out she's gonna have to stop.
She's gonna have to stop because One Direction fans brought it. They had over 12 million views. That's insane.
Well, I mean, they teased this thing all week.
Yes.
And we knew it was going to be completely bonkers.
Yes.
Because all the boys assume new alter egos.
Mm-hmm.
Who was your favorite?
When Zayn was the sexy assistant.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
It was so hideous.
Ooh,
it was beautiful.
But I love Leroy the choreographer.
When Leroy compliments Liam, complimenting himself.
Liam, you stay exactly where you are because you are perfect.
It holds the record now, so we're now seeing a lot of retaliation from Beliebers. They are trying to unite a whole bunch of other fandoms to come together to topple the new record. And I am happy to have helped that. I was tweeting along. I was, you know.
Yes, you were tweeting
along.
I was
saying, you know, let's all watch this. Let's unite. I was refreshing. I was watching it over and over.
You know, honestly, I think because we're here, I mean, we should just go right into your number two because it's kind of related.
Should we?
We should.
I mean, I can.
No, we have to because it's all related.
My number two is a little self-serving, but it was the most important thing that's ever happened to anybody ever, including you and you.
And no, listen, I know. When I saw what, tell the people.
Harry Styles retweeted me. Bye.
let's just top that now. How will we ever top that?
My phone is blowing up. It was the most important thing that has ever happened to me, besides like being birthed.
Yeah.
So Harry retweeted me and he included, so he quote tweeted my tweet. I was tweeting the link to the new video.
What did he say to you?
And he said, thanks, mate. And you know what that means. There's a lot of layers within what he's trying to tell me.
Harry called me mate.
I get the message loud and clear. Yes. As soon as it happened, I was like, I went into YouTuber mode and I was like, before I feel any emotions, let me turn on a camera.
Let me process this.
Because
it
didn't even get sent to my phone. Everyone started texting me. They're like, oh my God, Harry. And I'm like, oh my God, Harry, what? Did his nudes leak? And no, something even better.
Harry retweeted me.
I am not even going to attempt to top that.
That's fine.
You know, let's just let that live on its own.
What you got though?
And all its glory. But this is what I got. I got Spice Girls done by French boys in
this,
like 9-inch heels.
So perfect.
It's beautiful. It's a medley of our favorite Spice Girls songs done by three wonderful French dancers. It's all over Paris. They got their crew, they got their boys together to do like fun, like full on, like little dance routines. And then they're just like working it. Like, what
they
do you call the-
They are turning
in the
it
metro.
Out. This is going viral. I have seen every gay on my Facebook
posting this.
This is like huge. So if you haven't seen it yet, you need to watch
it. It'll just make your day.
It's very nostalgic. It brings back all the hits.
And also, they are fully having this like crazy campaign where they're trying to get the Spice Girls to react to this. So they're like tweeting it.
I'm all about this.
Get out there, get this video. You gotta tweet all the Spice Girls.
Send it to Posh. Send it to Scary.
Okay, so for our number ones, we're gonna transition a little bit. Obviously, we like to have a lot of fun on the show. But it's also important to us what you're talking about, what you care about. And last week, we were all really shocked and saddened by the tragic loss of Corey Monteith and Talia Castellano. So that's what we're going to talk about.
And I think a really important thing for us, especially when those things happened, was we wanted to take some time just to make sure that we had all of the facts and didn't report too quickly on something that impacted us a lot. And we knew it was important to talk about, so that's why we wanted to make it our number ones this week.
Yeah. So while we process all of this, obviously the loss of Corey just shocked fans, was so unexpected. And for his castmates who are you know, his brothers and sisters, I mean, they spend so much time together. And of course, his girlfriend, Lea Michele, it's like, how do you move on from this tragedy? Mm-hmm. And they all said, you know, going back to work is like the best way to kind of honor Corey. And he wanted to work, you know, mm-hmm. he told Ryan Murphy, like when he was having all these struggles with drugs, that like work was his salvation. So they know that this show is so special to him and to all of them. They're gonna have this two-part Beatles show. So we'll just, I mean, we'll get a lot of really great Beatles music, so we can look forward to that. And then in this third episode of the season, they're actually going to address Finn, and he will die in the episode. So that's going to be, we all know that's going to be amazing, like just so emotional for everybody. But what's, I think, been really special is that they've given the cast time to think about this. Lea Michele has blessed like every decision along the way. Mm-hmm. Like you said, all the fan support.
And that's one thing that I especially noticed was online, the support that all the fans had for each other. We saw every fandom come together and say, hey, Glee fandom, we're here for you. We support you. Let's all get through this together. And the love and the hope that was spread online was just something that I have never experienced. And that, when I saw that, it was just heartwarming for me to see, because I know that I was affected by it, and I know that you guys were affected by it. But to come together and to support each other during this was really important. And kind of in the same vein, we saw within the YouTube community the loss of Talia Castellano. And she was a makeup guru who was so good at what she did. She was a young girl who always just brightened people's day by showing makeup tutorials and doing reviews and things like that, and just becoming this YouTube sensation that gave hope to people. Because while she was making all of these videos, she was suffering from cancer. And she went on to be on The Ellen Show. She became an honorary cover girl. And she had so much hope and light about her that she just spread to her audience and to the world. And so within the past couple weeks, things took a turn, and we saw a lot of people online offering her support, whether it was Ellen or other YouTubers or everybody, just sending her love and light in her final days. And especially now that she has passed, we have seen so many people online, all of her fans, come together to complete her bucket list. And it's really an amazing thing to see her legacy live on through her fans, who are trying to live their lives to the best that they can because they want to honor her.
She's just so passionate and beautiful, and everything like shines out of her. So I think she taught us all very important lessons. So yeah. Lots of love to Talia and to her family and all her fans.
And in the words of her favorite quote, just keep swimming. So thank you guys, everyone, for watching. We will see you guys for another Top That next week. But until then, later, y'all.